ओके, वी आर लाइव।
नमस्कारा, गुड इवनिंग एंड अ वार्म वेलकम टू ऑल। बीएसकेबी एसोसिएशन, पॉपुलरली नोन एज गोकुल, इज अ 96 ईयर ओल्ड चैरिटेबल ट्रस्ट इन मुंबई एंड आर एक्टिविटीज इंक्लूड अ कम्युनिटी सेंटर एट सायन एंड अ होम फॉर सीनियर सिटीजन्स एट नेरोल इन नवी मुंबई। विद ओवर 5,000 मेंबर्स, वी हैव बीन एक्टिवली इंटरैक्टिंग फॉर रिलीजियस, कल्चरल एंड सोशल कॉजेस। Let's just have a quick look at the new Gokul building that is getting ready.
ನವೀಕರಣಗೊಂಡ ಗೋಕುಲ ಕಟ್ಟಡದ ವೈಶಿಷ್ಟ್ಯಗಳು. 7 ಅಂತಸ್ತುಗಳುಳ್ಳ ಗೋಕುಲ ಬೃಹತ್ ಸೌಧದಲ್ಲಿ 2 ತಳಮಜಲುಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಸುಮಾರು 70 ಕಾರುಗಳ ನಿಲುಗಡೆಗಾಗಿ ವ್ಯವಸ್ಥೆ ಮಾಡಲಾಗಿದೆ. ಅಲ್ಲದೆ ಸಾಂಸ್ಕೃತಿಕ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮಗಳಿಗಾಗಿ 225 ಆಸನಗಳುಳ್ಳ ಒಂದು ಸುಸಜ್ಜಿತ ಹವಾನಿಯಂತ್ರಿತ ಸಭಾಗೃಹ, 2 ದೊಡ್ಡ ಸಭಾಂಗಣಗಳು, ಭೋಜನಗೃಹ, ಆಧುನಿಕ ಸೌಕರ್ಯಗಳುಳ್ಳ 3 ಪಾಕಶಾಲೆ, ಸುಸಜ್ಜಿತ ವಾಚನಾಲಯ, 50 ಸದಸ್ಯರು ಆಸೀನರಾಗಬಹುದಾದಂತಹ ಸಮಾಲೋಚನಾ ಕೊಠಡಿ, ಆಡಳಿತ ಕಚೇರಿ, 12 ಅತಿಥಿ ಕೊಠಡಿಗಳು, ಮನರಂಜನೆಗಾಗಿ ಒಳಾಂಗಣ ಕ್ರೀಡೆ ಇತ್ಯಾದಿ ಚಟುವಟಿಕೆಗಳಿಗಾಗಿ ಕೊಠಡಿ, ವಿಶಾಲವಾದ ಟೆರೆಸ್, 3 ಮೆಟ್ಟಲ ದ್ವಾರಗಳು, 4 ಲಿಫ್ಟ್ಗಳು ಮುಂತಾದ ಸೌಲಭ್ಯಗಳನ್ನು ಹೊಂದಿರುವ ಅತ್ಯಂತ ಸುಂದರವಾದ ಕಟ್ಟಡ ಇದಾಗಿದೆ. ದಕ್ಷಿಣ ಕನ್ನಡ ಶೈಲಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ರೂಪುಗೊಂಡ ಶ್ರೀ ಗೋಪಾಲಕೃಷ್ಣ ದೇವಸ್ಥಾನದ ವೈಶಿಷ್ಟ್ಯಗಳು ಕುಸುರಿ ಕೆತ್ತನೆಗಳಿಂದ ರಚಿಸಲ್ಪಟ್ಟ ಬೂದು ಬಣ್ಣದ ಶಿಲಾಮಯ ಗರ್ಭಗುಡಿ, ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಕಪ್ಪು ಕಲ್ಲಿನ 44 ಕೇಶವಾದಿ, ವಿಷ್ಣುವಾದಿ ಹಾಗೂ ಸಂಕರ್ಷಣಾದಿ ಮೂರ್ತಿಗಳು, ಸುಮಾರು 36 ಅಡಿ ಎತ್ತರದ ಬೃಹತ್ ಗೋಪುರ, 14 ಅಡಿ ಎತ್ತರದ ಮರದ ಕೆತ್ತನೆಯುಳ್ಳ ಮಹಾದ್ವಾರ, ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಕೃಷ್ಣಾವತಾರಕ್ಕೆ ಸಂಬಂಧಪಟ್ಟ 28 ವಿವಿಧ ಪ್ರಕರಣಗಳ ಮರದ ಕೆತ್ತನೆಗಳು, 6 ಅಡಿ ಎತ್ತರದ ಕಲ್ಲಿನ ಜಯ ವಿಜಯ ದ್ವಾರಪಾಲಕ ಮೂರ್ತಿಗಳು, ಮೇಲ್ಗಡೆ 10 ಅಡಿ ಉದ್ದ 3 ಅಡಿ ಅಗಲದ ಅನಂತಶಯನ ದೇವರ ಮರದ ಕೆತ್ತನೆ, ಮಹಾದ್ವಾರದ ಒಳಗೆ ಹೋಗುವಾಗ 4 ಅಡಿ ಎತ್ತರದ ಪಂಚಲೋಹದ 2 ದೀಪಲಕ್ಷ್ಮಿಯರು, ಪ್ರವೇಶ ದ್ವಾರದ ಒಳ ಮೇಲ್ಮೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಉಡುಪಿ ಕಡೆಗೋಲು ಕೃಷ್ಣ, ಮಹರ್ಷಿ ವೇದವ್ಯಾಸರು ಗಣಪತಿಯಿಂದ ಮಹಾಭಾರತ ರಚಿಸುತ್ತಿರುವುದು, ಮಹರ್ಷಿ ವಾಲ್ಮೀಕಿಯಿಂದ ರಾಮಾಯಣ ರಚನೆಗಳ ಸುಂದರ ಕೆತ್ತನೆ, ದೇವಾಲಯದ ಮುಂಭಾಗದಲ್ಲಿರುವ ಹವಾನಿಯಂತ್ರಿತ ಸಭಾಗೃಹದ ಮೇಲ್ಮೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಶ್ರೀಕೃಷ್ಣಾವತಾರದ ಶ್ರೀಕೃಷ್ಣಲೀಲೆ, ಗೋವರ್ಧನ ಗಿರಿಧಾರಿ ಇತ್ಯಾದಿ ವಿವಿಧ ರೂಪಗಳ ಮರದ ಕೆತ್ತನೆಗಳು, ಮಧ್ಯಭಾಗದಲ್ಲಿ ಅರ್ಜುನನಿಗೆ ವಿಶ್ವರೂಪ ದರ್ಶನದ ಕೆತ್ತನೆಗಳು, ಅಲ್ಲದೆ ಗೋಡೆಗಳಲ್ಲಿ 4 ಅಡಿ ಎತ್ತರ 3 ಅಡಿ ಅಗಲದ ರಜತ ಪ್ರಭಾವಳಿಯಿಂದ ಅಲಂಕೃತ ಸ್ವರ್ಣ ಲೇಪದ ದಶಾವತಾರ ಮೂರ್ತಿಗಳು, ತೇಗದ ಮರ ಹಾಗೂ ಕಂದುಕಲ್ಲಿನಿಂದ ರಚಿತ ಅಲಂಕಾರಿಕ ತೀರ್ಥ ಮಂಟಪ, ತೀರ್ಥಭಾವಿ, ತುಳಸಿ ಬೃಂದಾವನ ಇತ್ಯಾದಿಗಳನ್ನು ಒಳಗೊಂಡಿದೆ.
The BSKB Youth Wing is conducting Sunday interactive sessions along with the Talent Hunt series. Today, we present to you the 13th episode of Sambhashana, an interview series. Our guest for today is Shri B. Nagaraja Rao, Director of Arrow Electricals India Private Limited, and he will be interviewed by Pranav Udupa. I welcome you both. I'll introduce Pranav first. Pranav is an electrical engineering student pursuing his master's at Technical University of Denmark, DTU. After completing his BTech in Electrical Engineering at VJTI Mumbai, he worked at Vedanta Aluminium Limited, Jharsuguda, Odisha, as an assistant manager before joining IIT Bombay as a junior research fellow, where he worked for 1.5 years. His present area of study is around development and integration of disturbed renewable energy resources in the energy grid. Most of his hobbies are reading books or watching science videos on YouTube. He also likes to learn new languages and presently is learning Danish. Gokul has been an integral part of his life since childhood. His intellectual and social persona has been molded by participating in the Children's Day events, children's workshops, and also the Bala Kalavrinda sessions. Growing up, he participated and volunteered in some of the youth wing activities whenever possible. Pranav also looks forward to visiting the new Gokul building as soon as the opportunity arises. I request Pranav to take over now.
Thanks, Tanvi, for the very, very detailed introduction. Just one correction there. It's not disturbed energy sources. It's distributed energy sources. So I'm not working with any disturbed right now, not studying anything disturbed. But anyways, thank you for the introduction. And like, it's my pleasure and honor basically to interview a Nagaraj uncle. Who, like, before I start with our conversation, let me just quickly introduce him. Like, Mr. B. Nagaraj Rao was born in Padubidri in 1963. After graduating with a BE from KREC Suratkal, now popularly known as National Institute of Technology Suratkal, in 1982, he came to Mumbai and worked for a private firm. After working for a couple of companies, he felt that he could be his best boss. And in 1985, he tried setting up his own firm. And by 1989, he set up Aero Engineers Limited along with his three partners. So from 1989 to today, his company has grown leaps and bounds and gained the faith and goodwill of many prestigious firms like BRC and other petroleum companies, pharma industry. Basically, his company makes control panels, which are electrical panels, which we'll be talking a lot more. And it's like in 2020, his company transitioned from being a partnership to being a private limited firm. So we'll be talking more. Since 1992, he's married to Lohita Aunty and has two daughters. With this introduction, I would like to start with our conversation. Welcome Nagaraj uncle to this session. And let me start from the start. So can you, like, going from your engineering days, so how did it come to your mind from being a child among six children or six siblings in Padubidri to taking up science and then going on and doing engineering at KREC? So tell us about your initial study days.
Thank you, Pranav. Thank you, Tanvi. First, actually, it is a very good initiative by BSKBA to start this Sambhashana series and engaging youngsters to take interviews, because I think even formulating questions is also a talent, because they ask questions relevant to their time, their field, and I think it is definitely beneficial to the youngsters. And Pranav is a ex-BGATI, he went to IIT Bombay. I think he is very genius. Also, it is a great honor for me to be introduced in this episode. Thanks, BSKBA. Now, regarding my childhood, so you are asking my journey up to Suratkal, KREC Suratkal. Okay, we are three brothers and three sisters, and I am the youngest of all. My father, he was a cook. He is a Babu Rao, famously known as Balamba Babu Rao, because our household name is Balamba. So Balamba Babu Rao, he was a very popular cook. And I went to Ganapati school in Padubidri. That was a Sanskrit school managed by the Admar Mat Council.
Oh, yeah.
Very disciplined school. So I studied Sanskrit right from third standard. Yeah. And then I went to Mulki Vijaya College. So every day I was commuting by bus. So actually many times I used to miss the bus because during the peak hour it is overcrowded and the bus, they were not stopping at bus stops. So I used to go early then, half an hour early. So I used to miss breakfast. So I was not taking lunch. Just I was drinking. I was in the afternoon, I drank only water and I was taking lunch only after coming back from the college. Because actually virtually we had no money. If I use the money for lunch, then how I will come out by bus? That was all the problem. Okay. And in school, actually, I was the stopper. I was studying well. And actually, I wanted to be See, I took science in the pre-university class. So for science, there were only three options at that time. Either you do BSc or engineering or medical, that's all. Nothing else. So I didn't join BSc because all my other friends, they joined BSc and we were waiting for the admission for engineering. Yes, it was late actually. But I didn't join BSc. I was very confident that I will get engineering seat. And even whenever I go to Bangalore, I used to see that KREC board roadside. So I wanted that I should join that call somehow. So that's how, and finally I got the call for the interview, counseling. So I went to Bangalore. Actually, my preference was to take electronics. And there the counselor said, if you want electronics, you can't join KREC. Then you have to join some other college. If you want KREC, then you have to take electrical that is available, electrical or any other branch. And he also convinced me that electrical is also good subject. Actually, I don't know why he started convincing me. Okay, I also thought, okay, then KREC is a government college. And the fees was actually almost zero. It was like a free education. I was staying at hostel and only I have to pay the mess bill. So I thought that, okay, KREC is okay. That's how I joined KREC. Yeah, that was my journey from Padubidri to KREC.
Was really quite inspiring, like coming from a modest background, working your way up, sacrificing in terms of food and like hardships that like you, the people of your generation have to go to. And also, like when you mentioned Ganapati school, it just struck me that, oh, I had heard about this. Like if you visit Admar Mata, and they have a huge board of their institutions, like there are around 23 or 24. I don't remember the recent numbers, but yeah, the amount of land they have touched by their educational institutes. Like including my father, like even he has been a part of Admar Mata Institute for a long, long time, like working for Puna Prajna High School in Dahisar. And the transformation it brought to his life and also to my life. So huge shout out to them for this initiative. And like getting back to the conversation, and is there any event from your young days that shaped up or inspired your thoughts or that molded your thoughts? Can you share an anecdote about what were your inspirations during a student life?
See, actually I was good in studies, that my mother recognized that. See, so she started forcing me to study well always. She was also literate. In those days, in 1920s, she attended up to 5th standard. She could read English letters. So she saw that this boy studying, so let me force him so that his future will be bright. Maybe. That was her thought. She was continuously forcing me, and she wanted me always to be a topper in the class. Even if I slipped to second position, again she will force me. And actually I remember one incident. I was very small, maybe third standard or so. So one, you know, Mr. General Karyappa, he was the retired field marshal at
KC Karyappa. Yes.
Once he visited the school in the evening, and we were all made to assemble near that flag hoisting pole outside, first to 10th standard. So he was maybe felicitated and garlanded. So he might have given some speech, I don't recollect. Then finally, he asked everybody to say Jai Hind. He raised your hand and say Jai Hind. So we all said Jai Hind. Again, he said you have to say still louder. And I think I shouted so loud, he saw me and he called me. Oh, so I was afraid actually. Why he is calling me? I was a very small kid. So I went there. He lifted me. He made me stand on the table. And he put his garland on my neck. And he asked me my name and all. I don't know what else he asked. But I became so famous. And even before I reached my home, my mother came to know that. whole neighborhood came to me. I don't know how. So after that, my mother was continuously forcing me. She was telling everybody, this boy, even the General Karyappa garlanded him, that this, and that's how really she made me to study well. That's how I could really join KRAC. And I think she is the one who shaped me. That's what I feel.
That's really inspiring, like to be recognized by like a person like General Karyappa. And that's huge, especially in that stage of life. And also like getting back to recognitions, I'd like to congratulate you on your recent award that you got, being recognized by KREC for your entrepreneurship. So can you tell us how you felt about being recognized by your alma mater?
Yeah, like actually,
how did you feel?
Mm-hmm. See, KREC, it is a college where 50% of the students are from outside state and only 50% from Karnataka. So they have alumni association here, and now they have alumni in each and every state. So in Mumbai also the association was there. I came across one Mr. Yadunarayan Shetty. He was also ex-KREC. He had a factory and he was setting up a factory at Goa also. He was staying at Andheri. So once I met him, so he made me the member of the alumni association. Also, he gave me an order also for his Goa plans. Because he wanted only I would give first preference to my school, the college. That's what he said. And I was attending there, but only elder people were only the members for the association. Because at that time, there was no social media, no contact, no touch. Once you leave the college, we don't know who went where. Because now we have got so much contact, you know, each and everybody who is doing what. But at that time, that was not the case. There are very few members. And recently, some 3 years back, there was a global conference. So now they conduct global conference every 2-3 years in every state. So in 3 years back, it was at Mumbai. So I was actively participated in that. And see, this Gurraj Bhatt, he is also ex-KREC. And also, I am proud to say he was one of the member of BSKBA member. He donated handsomely for this project also. Yes, very, very genius and brilliant person. So we lost him actually. So in his memory, this alumni started one award. So that entrepreneurship award. So I am lucky to be the first person to get that award in 2020. And I'm really proud and I really thank alumni for that.
Yeah. That's really good to hear. That's commendable. Congratulations again for your for the achievement. And like now I would like to like ask you more about your life after college. Like after your graduation, you moved to Mumbai. And what were your first impressions of Mumbai? Were there any culture shocks per se? That you had like difference in cultures that you had while in Mumbai for the first time. Any lessons you would like to share with me, since I have moved from India to Denmark. Before that, I moved from Mumbai to Orissa for some time. It is quite difficult transitioning, and like it is, but it is also a part of life. If you have to get what you want, you have to move from out of your comfort zone, like where you're staying in this regard. So what were your first experiences in Mumbai? Like about your first job and how was it?
Actually, first I will tell how I came to Mumbai. My one very close family friend, my uncle, one Vasudeva Rao, Padubidri Vasudeva Rao, who was staying at Santa Cruz. So after my graduation, he called me for one interview here. So I got a call for the interview, and I have to rush to Mumbai immediately. The next day or within 2 days, I was to come. So suddenly my another brother, my one cousin Venkatraja Rao. He was also staying in Bombay, and he was running a shop across the Matunga Central Railway. Yeah. So he was fortunately at home on that day, and he was to leave to Bombay on the same day. So immediately ran to him. So he was to leave by the morning bus. So he took me to the bus stop. He arranged my ticket for the evening bus. And then I had some 600 rupees with me. And I loaned a bag from my sister. So I caught hold of, boarded that afternoon bus. And the next day I came to Bombay. And my brother, he was standing there in the Sion bus stop. So he took me to my another uncle. Uncle means, I don't call him as uncle, he's my chikappa, Setu Madhav Rao. Yeah, he was staying at Girgaon. Setu Madhav Rao, he also worked for BSKBA. You know our Girish grandfather. You may be knowing. Tanvi's great grandfather. Yes, yes. So he was staying at Girgaon. So I went there. And the next day I attended the interview. And I got the job at Andheri. That's how I started my career in Bombay. And even, it is a new city, yes, of course. But my first of all, my Hindi was very good. Because, I studied Hindi for 3 years. Then in our Suratkal College, I said 50% were from outside states. They were all my friends. We were speaking Hindi, English, and I came to know about that culture. That means culture of whole India.
Yeah.
Because we had students from each state.
Yes.
So even we were celebrating Holi and other festivals because I was staying at hostel also. So I think I didn't find any problem when I came to Mumbai. Because everything was easy. I could freely mingle with people. I talked to people. And of course, the train was crowded, but I always used to travel in the opposite direction from Girgaon to Andheri, or then I shifted my residence to Pejawarmat. Because in Pejawarmat, we had rooms at that time in the first floor, there were rooms. See, now also there are rooms in the one side. Those days, there were rooms on both sides. Now they have made one side rooms to one hall.
Yes.
So we were staying 5-6 people per room. All like bachelors came from our net.
Yes.
So I went there also. So that's how from there I was going to the company. So that was also opposite direction. And even I had another cousin, another Mr. Vasudev Rao. He was staying at Kurla. Okay, he's my cousin brother. So I met him, and he used to take me on holidays and he made me meet all our community people, socialize me, and even he was supplying materials to ONGC. So even I got an order to supply material to ONGC Bombay High also because of it.
Nice.
So that's why I mingled with the people, and I didn't find any problem actually. But even, in Bombay, Hindi is also not required. Even broken Hindi is also okay. That's what we have seen. But of course, in other state, I don't know. But we should be confident. Only we have to be alert. We should be confident that nothing to worry. We should be freely mingled. I don't think it is a big thing to... Because you are also in Denmark. Whether you have faced any problem, I don't know. But I don't think so. Just we should be confident. That's all. What is there to be afraid?
Yes, that's a very right point you have said. You need to be confident in your abilities, and you need to be confident. And also, it was also very lucky for you to have relatives to help you get around and get used to the community there. And even that helped in your initial days. So, that was very good to hear. A sense of community is always required. You cannot be your own world, kind of. You need people to share your emotions. That's one of the main things that have been highlighted in today, where people say they are connected, but it's people are getting more and more isolated. So, That was a really good point you put forth. And like coming back to the sequence of your journey, so like from being under a boss to being your own boss, what were your first inspirations of entrepreneurship, and what were your what were your learnings from your initial entrepreneurship days? Well, you said like your first ventures didn't go very well, then you get back, because most of the time entrepreneurship is very glorified and it's all sunshine and rainbows. That's how they show it in movies anyways. So you like startup kholenge, paisa hi paisa hoga, agla Jeff Bezos mein hai. Like, but mostly if you study entrepreneurs, it is like it's not their first venture that becomes a success. It is they never give up. It is their determination, and after two or three ventures they get success, like, and you get to know them by their brands. So can you tell us about your entrepreneurship journey, like how you started with it basically?
See, first I was working when I came to Bombay. I worked for one company called Gyro Laboratories. That was at MIDC Andheri. Now the company is not there. They closed down the company. So I started working there. And I didn't like that the manager there. The boss was very good. The owner was very good. But I didn't like the manager. For all my good deeds, he was taking the credit. That normally happens everywhere.
Yeah.
So, and even before also, even otherwise also, see, my uncle Chikappa, he's a very dynamic person. I heard he was manufacturing radios. I don't know. I have not seen. But some Balamba radios, very famous radio. Somebody said the quality was also very good in long back. He was a very dynamic and he had a real entrepreneurship. And he had also an industrial place at Pune. So he was manufacturing some rubber component and all. And even his sons were taking care of the industry. And whenever he came to our native, there also he was not keeping quiet. You know, he was used to sell this coconut oil in parachute-like plastic bottle. Used to sell tea powder packets. I don't know. He was like a typical person. I don't think he never sat quietly. So I was very much inspired by him. And one day he called me also to Pune. There is some spare capacity. Can you suggest whether we can do something? Then these Gyro Laboratories, they are manufacturing test benches. That mm-hmm. is electrical test benches. So I thought we can start it there. But actually it didn't happen. But somehow I thought that I should do something. And this manager, I said, say, I will narrate some incident in that Gyro. Actually, it was an electric company. And one day that company owner brought one machine, washing machine for repair.
Okay.
Maybe his friend's machine, maybe somebody might have given him because it was not working. He dumped the machine in front of me and said, just check. First of all, I didn't know what is this machine. For the first time, I am seeing that washing machine. Oh. So I didn't figure out what that machine was. Then I and my assistant, another assistant was there. We were just trying to see what is that machine. Okay, we understood. There is some washing machine. And there were all electronic components. We don't know anything, how to open that. Then, I thought, let us at least trace the circuit, whatever circuit is visible, wire. We will trace the circuit. I traced all the wire and found that in one place the wire was, I think it was bitten by rat and all. There was some loose connection. So we replaced the wire and the machine started working. And I don't know how the machine works also. Just it made sound, it worked, something. I said, manager, okay. After 4 hours, I said, the machine is working now. Okay, he said. The next day that person came, the owner of the machine. So this manager, he started explaining. I instructed this boy to do that. I did that. He did that. He was dancing and explaining in such a way. I got angry. I have done everything. And he's telling as if everything is done by him. I really got angry. No, I should not blame him actually. But okay, I just remember. And another incident was there. After joining the company, after 3-4 months, the company owner started me sending to sending for commissioning and servicing of the machines all over India. I don't know why he chose me. Maybe my Hindi was good, or I can mingle or communicate with persons, people properly. So he started sending me. So I had a shoe which I had bought from the roadside. So that shoe was torn. So I had some excess money. So I said that accountant, see, my shoe has torn. I will buy one shoe at least from this money. So I bought one shoe and handed over the bill to that accountant. And promptly the next month, in the salary, they deducted this shoe amount. And I was working for the company. So I asked the manager, I told the accountant and I wanted to buy the shoe because this shoe was torn because I am moving to so many places. He said, no, we are not giving you shoe and all. We cannot give. So I thought that I should leave the company immediately. Somehow I got a job in another company where they were also manufacturing a control panel only. So another company at Andheri only, Sakinaka. So I joined there. So there actually, again I thought that now I have to do something. After joining there, after 1 year, I left the company and thought of starting my own. I just resigned from the company. And I started a company called Amaya Power Controls. That is actually in 1988.
Okay.
And after 3-4 months, actually I got an order also. Order for supplying some 5 feeder pillar VC, those red boxes you might have seen, which are installed on the roadside. That is electricity board. They are installing the panels. They are called as feeder pillars. I got order for 5 feeder pillars. So I started fabrication and suddenly I came to know that I have no money even to have food also. And it was so foolish of me, just like that we start without thinking anything and without analyzing anything. Just like that I started. So when I found that I have no money, so I joined the third company. The company's name was Square Automation, where actually I met my other two partners. Actually, our aero engineers, we are 3 partners, me and my other two partners. And I was knowing them even before also. So that's how, so I joined that company, Square Automation. So there we were managing the whole show in the company. Right from quoting tender to final execution of that job, design, everything. So again, we thought we can start a company on our own. I had already a good experience of burning my hand still. Okay, again, we will start because I wanted to start. So again, we thought that we will start. And we are 3. See, we are 3 from different states, from different religion. I am from the southernmost Karnataka. The other one, Mr. Sanjeev Kinnavar, my other partner, is from middle border of Maharashtra and Karnataka. Belgaum. Uh-huh. And the another one is Mr. Bhagavat Vani. He is from northernmost Maharashtra, yes, Jalgaon. Yes. So we 3 started this company called Aero Engineers. Now how to start? This is also one thing. Again, we are all of the same condition, no money. Yes. No one has money. They are all of like same. Our condition was same. Then how to start? So our Vani, what he did, he left the company and we both started paying him 1,000 each salary from our pocket. Because he should run his show also, right? And yeah, he should run his home also. Yeah. So we started paying him 1,000 each from our salary and he started moving around. He got order. Then we rented a place at Sakinaka in one hut, you can say. So we invested 10,000 each. That was the only money we could afford to invest. That is in 1989 December we started this. And then after a couple of months, see, actually we did very well in the December to March also. We did some 4 lakh turnover and with a very good profit. I don't know. We were lucky also to have that and we did worked hard also. So that's how after a couple of months, once the company started growing, I left my job and I joined this company. After 1 year, Sanjeev also joined the company. And still we are, it is, this December we will be completing 32 years for this company.
Nice.
Yeah. So we started manufacturing a low voltage control panel. And now we have diversified into high voltage also, 11,000 volt, 11 kV, 22 kV, 33 kV. That's how we are doing.
Yeah. Nice. It's really good to hear your journey, because like days, they, I heard it somewhere, like bad days make for good stories, and good stories is what makes our life interesting. So it was like, in hindsight, looking at hindsight, it really is a very good inspiration and learning curve that you have got. And like, and you have also mentioned about some technical terms which are in like particular to electrical engineering domain, but like I'd like to ask you to explain what a test bench would be and what would be a control panel, and like what exactly do you do, because electrical engineering, unlike maybe mechanical or civil, no blaming them or something, you can't really see it outside explicitly, and everything is concealed, and only when it doesn't work, people realize, oh, where's the electrical guy, call him in, like we need to get this fixed. So can you explain us in brief what do you mean by a control panel and a test bench, and like some technical terms that you used in the previous question? So basically, control panel, and what do you do make in your firm?
See, test bench is totally different from control panel. Test bench that is used to test and calibrate the meters. See, energy meter also, whatever energy meter we have at residence or at factory, earlier we used to have analog meters, that big meters and all. Now they are all, most of the meters are digital. So test the meter and to calibrate the meter, and there are so many protection relays in the panel.
Yes.
The protection relays are required to protect the circuit and protect the installation and people from short circuit, overload, or fire, anything. So we install relays in the panel, many type of relays which protect the electrical installation. So to test the relay, also these test benches are used. And but in control panel, this control panel is mainly used for control and distribution of electric power. So it is totally different. Suppose you take a generating station. Now we have got so many type of generating station. And from generating station, the power is transmitted through transmission lines to substation. There the power is stepped down from high voltage to our normal voltage, which is our three phase. If it is three phase, it is 415 volt.
Yes.
And for single phase at our residence, it is 230 volt. In the three phase only, the phase to neutral is 230 volt and the phase to phase is 415 volt. So that is, everybody knows that.
Hope
so. So after stepping down the power, see, control panel is required everywhere to distribute the power. This is, I am talking about low voltage control panel. In high voltage control panel, that is, see, 11 kVR, 12, 22 kVR, 33 kV. These are installed before the transformer.
Yes.
And low voltage panels are installed after the transformer.
Yes.
So in control panel, there is a main panel. Again, there are so many divisions, so many type of panels which are distributing power to various sections, and these panels are required everywhere. In each installation, that is required, whether it is even high-rise building or paper mill, textile mill, sugar mill. See, we have supplied to almost all type of sectors. Cold storage plants, milk dairies, pharma companies, hotels, hospital. We have supplied to many hospitals. That's entire Saifi hospital, you know, near that Cherni Road.
Yeah.
That is powered by our panel. And there are so many hospitals. There is a Bombay hospital in Jaipur, Tata Memorial Cancer Hospital, and at Kharghar also, and at Vizag, and even we have supplied to data center. Now data center is the new sector where, you know, so many data is required because of this online job and all commercial complex. Even we supply to Venkatesh Stadium also, where they play the cricket. And also we got a big breakthrough because we got approval from the BRC, that Bhabha Atomic Research Center, which has stringent quality checks. They inspect at each stage. So we are approved there also. That is a big thing what we did. And actually we have supplied to BSKBA, our association. I am very glad to say that. And this these panels are installed at the basement. Anybody can go and see that. And this is the current right time to see, because once the BSKB, our Gokul building, becomes live, then it may become restricted area. So go and see now itself how the panels are, so people get an ID. And now the panel, now there are so many new technologies. Now there is a digitalization. So we started providing complete solution. It is not that we are only manufacturing supply control panels. We also have to do remote monitoring, remote control, and there are so many things involved. Now there are so many new load, like UPS or LED lights, and even this renewable energy, solar, you say. See, here all what happens, these powers are not pure. These are all impure power because of that DC. There we are converting DC to AC again.
Yes.
So that is not the pure power, and that generates, there is a term,
harmonics,
you know, but many people may not know. So we have to control that harmonics also. So technologically, in technology wise also, we should keep update, and we have to modify the panels. Again, there is discrimination. Suppose there is a short circuit in our home, just I am giving example, or something happened at our home, whether our MCB should trip, or whether that main MCB breaker should trip. Of course, our MCB should trip.
Yeah.
Because of the fault at our residence, we can't, the entire area cannot lose the power. So that is called a discrimination. This we have to implement in our panels also. So there are so many new technologies where you can remotely control the power. Even we can monitor the power, switch on and off from our mobile also. Nowadays,
yes.
So much technology is advanced. So all these things we are implementing, and that's all.
Yeah. So that's really good to hear. Like electrical engineering being highlighted, because it's basically so ubiquitous. Like it's there everywhere, but the thing is, you don't see it anywhere. Like, You might marvel at an amusement park ride, oh, that's a good ride, or a building, oh, that's a beautiful building, what kind of architecture. Say, for example, Saifi Hospital, say it's an hospital, but like if you look from outside, it looks like a five-star hotel. But like if you see within, like the electrical part, it's basically one of the most neglected part, or people don't appreciate. Like, how would you appreciate electrical network's beauty? Oh, what a wiring. No.
Yeah, actually, I want to add one thing. See, electrical, when we manufacture panels, we manufacture as per the safety standard. Because electricity, see, handling is very important. Because if you mishandle it, gone. Because we hear about so many fires in the building and all. Those are all due to negligence. So even when we supply to high-rise building and all, or any building, they don't provide proper electrical room, many of the people. Because space is very costly in cities or in Bombay. So they say, why we should, we have space for our own thing, not for your panels. That also I had many people telling. So again, in this case, what we have to do, we have to manufacture in such a way that even all adverse conditions also, they work in the adverse condition. Because panel means, that is not like that should long the age lifetime of this panel is more than 25 years. It is called as capital item. It is not like an item where you replace within 1 year or so. So we have to take lot of precaution. So we manufacture as per the standards. There are Indian standards derived from the European standards. There are so many tests involved. So we manufacture prototype panels, and we test at the NABL laboratories. Again, we get the certification, and only then we can manufacture the pan. It is not that anybody can do that. Yes. So then only they comply the safety standard, and that's how we have to work. So yeah. That is a huge investment to test the panel for various short circuit ratings or for various current ratings. So many tests involved. The dust should not enter, or dust should not get heated up. So all the things we have to see as per the site condition.
Yes. Like in one of the earlier slides, it was mentioned the control panel is certified for IP55.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
For those who don't know, IP55 stands for ingress potential. Like, and 55 or 68 or whatever number comes first. Like, there are two numbers. The first number stands for the dust, how much of dust can the panel handle, and the second number stands for moisture. I don't know if I'm mixing the order, but I remember this from my when I worked for Vedanta. Even there, it was one of the first questions my senior asked me, "Tujhe pata hai kya IP kya hota hai?" And it was kind of, I had just read it a couple of days ago. IP stands for ingress potential, and I told him, and he was quite impressed. So that was one of my and also
about even control, even in the cell phone also they mention what is that IP.
Yes,
if you see, so you can dip it in the water also and nothing happens. That is stringent IP.
Yes,
it is a general word.
You have the most expensive phones, like even for example, if you see iPhone ads, they endorse it for having being water resistant or something, but always fine print of IP. Yes. So for people who don't know IP, now you know. And coming on to your journey as an electrical engineer, how have your roles changed over the last 35 years of being a practicing electrical engineer, and how have you managed to keep yourself updated? Also, I would like to know if you have some anecdotes from your industry, one of the cases were for BARC, if you have some anecdotes from them, how they wanted you to make upskill yourself. You have to learn something new for some new product. If you got a new challenge with some assignment, and how did you face it?
Okay, see this. First of all, I am fortunate that after studying electrical engineering, I am into the same electrical field.
Yes.
I just remembered because I saw many of my batchmates after doing electrical, they were going to finance or some other field. That also I have seen. So I am in the electrical field, and I started manufacturing these panels and earlier test benches. And in this control panel, see, control panel, how we manufacture, suppose when we get an inquiry, the inquiry is generated by electrical consultant. First, there is an architect who construct the building or industry, whatever it is. He appoint electrical consultants. Electrical consultant, he makes the load list and the electrical detail, and he pass it on to us. So we have to accordingly do the estimation. Accordingly, we have to design. We have to see the, first we have to see the requirement. We have to see the specification. And the consultant means it should be really updated. We should know the new things. We also move in the market, so we also know what are the new technologies. And even, see, we buy switch gear. Switch gear means all those electrical items which we mount inside the panel. Even they also have to be keep updated as per the time. They have to manufacture products as per latest technology, and we also have to adapt, and there are so many electrical journals, so that is very important that we keep the things updated, because it is not that, see, there are new things, new protection, there are new faults, for that we have to find solutions, and that's how we do that. So we should be really keep updated.
That's really good to know, because the learning never ends. Like many people rightly say, you learn. The only way you keep yourself young is by keep learning. So that's really good, and reinforcing the way you said it, it reinforces my personal beliefs as well. Like, you need to keep learning, you need to keep yourself updated. If you stagnate, that will be the end of you. And
yes, and, for example, when we supply the panels to data center, suppose, see, now the data center, there are so many data centers coming up, and there the power interruption of power, that is not at all preferred, because even a interruption of 1 minute power may cost them a crores.
Yes.
So for that, they ask us to use latest technology switch gears. They ask us to provide so many safety interlocks. We have to prepare logic in such a way that there is no power interruption. And suppose the power fails, immediately the UPS, uninterrupted power supply, that has to take over. Then generator has to take over, because UPS that works only for some minimum time, right? Half an hour, 1 hour.
Yes,
then immediately the generator has to take over. So we have to prepare all those logics. We have to make complex circuits for these. And many times these generators are synchronized for higher power. So we have to make that synchronizing panel. And we also manufacture AMF, auto main failure panel. That means whenever the main electricity supply fails, maybe electricity board and all, immediately this other power should take over. First, the generator had to start, then it should take over. Yes. So many complex panels we are manufacturing nowadays. So we have to use PLC for that. Just wiring will not do. So PLC, programmable logic controllers. It is like a computer. Yes. So we have to use that. We have to do complex programs, and we have to do circuits. So now it is not so easy as it used to be earlier.
It is with digitization. And basically, one thing I like what you mentioned, like you need to be really very reliable. Like for electrical engineers, our products are such that you ignore all your life, but once they fail, it becomes headline news the next day, and the damage is significant. So there is even a momentary failure is not acceptable in terms of electrical. Also, we are sadly the most neglected part in terms of when it comes to infrastructure. Like you said about some builders telling you, we only have so much space. We only have so much space for your panels. Like even if within that space, you need to make sure all the safety and performance regulations are maintained. So that is one very prevalent aspect of electrical engineers that you have highlighted. Like moving on to your association with Gokul and your community, like we talked about earlier, our sense of community helped or eased your transition from Suratkal to Mumbai having accommodation, getting to know people of our community. And how has been your association with BSKB and Gokul, and how have you seen it transition over the years?
Okay, actually, when I came to Mumbai, since I was staying at Pejavarmal, I knew about Gokul. So we used to go there only on holidays, maybe on August 15 or January 26. We used to have cultural functions. We used to go just to have lunch and to have time pass. Yeah. That was the only thing at those times. There was no emotional attachment.
Yeah.
And even I tried to be member of, I am talking about 1980s, before 90s. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So even there were restrictions for membership. Once I asked them to make me member, they said already there are so many members, we have to wait. So that was I should not call it as mindset, but there were some problems. Because even there was no proper space. And after that, I only used to attend if any functions are there, I used to attend. And after my children were born, we used to take them for Children's Day competition. That's it, nothing more. But I think now it is totally different. the transformation is totally huge. See, they built Ashraya, that senior citizen home. That is a real, very, very good initiative. And now this new building is coming up. It's so much, such a magnificent infrastructure.
Yeah.
Such a modern amenities. It's such a beautiful temple. It's so much wooden carvings, stone idols. So it is really good. Actually, hats off to our Dr. Suresh Rao for his vision and vision to transform this place. Because I don't think no one else would have dared to even dream of such an idea. So it is too great.
Yeah.
So actually, I think this will become a landmark. And when there is a list of sightseeing in Mumbai, this place also will be one place. That's what I feel. There are so many initiatives, see, Vidyanidhi, and actually it is totally changed. And see, with having such a modern building and all, what I feel, our youth people, now they can go there, they can assemble, let them assemble at least once in a month, at least not online, offline. Go there and assemble. And discuss about new ideas, bring new initiatives, try to unite the our community, because still so many people are not going there. So we have to put confidence in them. We have to socialize them. After all, we are all outsiders, and we have come to Mumbai. So it is very important that we should unite and show our strength so that we can get our work done. That is very important. So it is totally, it is very good, and I am sure these things will bring confidence in the community. So we are, even my wife is, Loita is also actively involved. She also took so many, she is very good in art and craft. She also gave some classes there in BSKBA. So it is really, really,
right when I was participating, that was like 2010 or something. Like even then she had art and craft classes, and every time it was like mostly themed around making the best of like things you normally throw away, best out of waste. Look, it was like well organized and well done. So like, yeah, so like I said, like Loita auntie, even from my participating days to the time I used to go as a volunteer, I used to learn a lot in those sessions, like in terms of art and craft, like, but the technique and as well. And also like you said, a sense of community is very important for us, because humans after all are social animals. And
yes,
we being as immigrants, like most of our problems can only be understood by people like us who have managed to like get a better managed to settle down and get better established. So like, and also like you said, the transition from just function to a holistic year the round activities and involvement community center is really what we as youngsters should thank the management for. So like, before we move on to the concluding part, let us just show some glimpses of your company and of your industry, what you exactly do. So here
this is our picture. Let me explain. This is the punching machine, because we have to cut and bend the steel and make the cabinet for the panel. So this is one turret punching machine which is shown in the picture. This is the operation. We'll be right back. This is just to show how the machine works. This is our punching machine for these bars, copper or aluminium bars, which we are supposed to use in the pan. Because that is the bars which used for the interconnection, copper or aluminium. And they are supposed to be very pure, 100% pure aluminium and copper we are supposed to use, because commercial grade bars are not, it is not suitable for conducting electricity. So these are all special bars. This is a machine where you can show the video. Here the bars are cut and punched and shared, and we have to do bender. That was a bending, steel bending. This is only for for a common man. That is of interest. That's why we are showing that how the machine works. This is the bending. Here we bend the steel. Yeah. That is over. This same bending, another bending machine. These are all imported machine for accuracy we are using. This is how, this is a one glimpse of testing, how the things are tested. There are so many tests, and one test will be shown. This is for high voltage test, where we have to apply 2500 volt and test the panels. This is the metal purity tester, where we test purity of aluminium and copper, because we require 100% pure grade of metals. This is our one shop floor, where some panels are shown. We have epoxy coated floor, and there is a air evaporative system for cool air that we have installed to make it dust free atmosphere. So our factory is fully dust proof and cool. This is one of our training center, where we can accommodate some 50 people and give various type of trainings. It is known as Vidya Vatika. It is just our a part of our workforce, staff, workers.
So it's really good to see that you take care of your employees in upskilling them as well, like not just keep on hiring new people as the skills go, like skills get different. That's really good, the initiative that you have, like, because
it's retaining. Retaining people are very important, because we train them so much. So it is very important to retain that they are sincerely work for us. And again, we need not give training to new people, and they work properly. So our headache is reduced.
Yeah. Also, they know your company culture, and they work as per your quality standards. It's how you build a brand, how customers come for your brand, and how your company has become so trustworthy among so many diverse sectors. Like in the previous slide, we had seen like how diverse it was, like from hospitals to institutes, to industries, to research areas like BRC. Like the list is quite expansive and quite diverse. So like it's a good message, it's a really good learning step for young entrepreneurs as well, like to retain your staff and retrain them, keep them updated and so on. I feel it's good time to come to the concluding part of this wonderful conversation I've had with you, and I would like to know what would be your message to the younger generation, and what changes do you see in terms of mindset in the younger people that you that you see, like, and what would be your words of wisdom to people who will be watching this video, maybe live or maybe down the line?
Younger generation, today's younger generation, let me tell you, they are very smart. Where you are smart, actually they only teach us. Very intelligent, they have so much knowledge, they have so much information, their communication is very good, they all keep in touch, they have got so many, see, even information is very easily available. In our time, you have to read books, we don't know what is happening. So I said, even after our friends, after leaving the college, we didn't know where they are. And now, after so many years, we formed a WhatsApp group. Now I know who are working where.
Yeah.
Otherwise, it was like a blind. We don't know what is happening in the world. Only we have to talk to people or we have to read. Only then we come to know. But now it is not the case. Now information is available on fingertips. And people are smart also. So they are very intelligent. They can really take decision. So only take correct decision, that's all. Take guidance from the elders and take correct decision. Otherwise, really, really great. Because even I see younger generation telling fathers, sir, you don't know anything. You know so many things. It is fact. We don't know anything. Because the information is freely available. See, in our, during my time, I applied one phone for one MTNL and I took 1.5 to 2 years to get the connection at that time. It was really very bad at those times. But now it is not like that way. You chat, within a second, the other one, you can share videos, everything you can do now. When I got the interview call, it was through a telegram. There was no phones and all. No? So I saw the postman has brought a telegram. When we received the telegram, we were worrying at that time. Because telegram means we used to say there is some bad messages come. It was that way. But now it is not like that way. So it is, I think, younger generation are very good, only take guidance from elders and they can do it.
You are being very humble in that regard, because like as I see it, it's too much of information, and we need elders help to filter those information between relevant and irrelevant, because the most 99% of the information that you have is mostly irrelevant, and you need some experience, you need vision to like filter to know what's right for you, and that's where elders play a significant role. And also, just a side note, how did you name your company as Arrow Engineers? What was the story? Or like,
see, there is no story actually. We just said that we wanted to do. See, why we started, because we wanted to start. We want to get rid of that company so that we can earn some money, some more money, so that now we can travel by auto also. See, that is why we used to travel by bus. We have no money for auto. Let us earn something more so that we'll travel by auto or a taxi. After that, we can travel by two-wheeler once we have more money. So we sat together and we wanted to form a company. And see, Arrow means suddenly it came to our mind. I don't recollect actually how it came. These 32 years back story. But I think Arrow means it always moves forward. Arrow means it moves forward. That's what we thought our company should move forward. Let us take it forward. We let the company grow. Let so many people work so that even their families also grow with us. That was the thought. No other thought. That was the only thought. Now it has become a brand, Arrow. Now it is very famous.
Yeah. That was quite motivating to hear as well. And also, I have learned a lot in this interview or in this conversation or interview, like they formally call it. I'd like to call it a conversation, but for me, it was pretty enlightening. Like how, from modest means, like your journey, I resonate a lot, because my father used to tell me about his days, and even he is from that era. Like you are from similar age group, so I find a lot of similarities like between you and my father in terms of their journeys, how from modest means you come to Mumbai, find a community and grow professionally as well as personally within the community and outside the community as well, find new people. And like, it's kind of inspiring to me as I do my, as I like, I'm setting out on my journey. So really inspiring. And also not to mention the fact that an electrical engineer, you don't find that many in Mumbai, at least these days. Most of them, like you said, diverse out into finance or diverse out into business or like proper administration. To stick with your engineering, your bachelor's level, and make something worthwhile come out of it, because it's kind of trending. Like people say, engineering aise hi kar liye, fir in your graduation ke baad jo man tha wo kar liye. So like when people degrade engineers, saying that they're not good and they end up doing MBA and they end up doing stand up comedy, like completely unrelated, you often see people like citing examples of them. So being one of those people who have stuck to a core principle like electrical engineering, as well as being from Gokul, like a thought came to my mind, like Gokul, we know so little about our members, and like it's like Kasturi Mruga, like you say in Kannada, like we, the fragrance is within ourselves, the talent is within ourselves, but even we are not aware of our talented individuals we
yes,
have
right.
of the mm-hmm. So this Sambhashana series, at least for me, has been a very good platform to know people and get to know people like you, people, the other people that have been interviewed so far. And like, I really thank BSKBA and the Gokul Youth Wing to give me an opportunity after, like, to associate with the Youth Wing activity after 5 years. So with this, I would like to like stop talking a little, and with this I would like to conclude. And thank you so much, Nagaraj uncle. It was great interacting with you, and it was really very inspiring for me personally a lot. And thank you so much, and over to you, Tanvi.
Thank you Pranav, and thank all the thank you Tanvi, Gurraj, and all the BSKB association. It was really nice, and it was really interesting questions, and I liked the way you questioned and you answered. It was really, really.
Thank you so
I
much,
knew. Yeah. Okay. Thank you.
Thanks to Pranav for beautifully conducting today's interview of Shri B. Nagaraj Rao. Each and every aspect was covered really very well. A huge thanks to Nagaraj uncle for being a part of today's interview. Hearing about your journey really made us happy and definitely inspired all of us. I'm sure that your words of wisdom paved way for youngsters to be confident enough to take up electrical engineering and also to be one's own boss. Thank you so much for sharing your valuable time and knowledge with all of us. I would also like to thank the audience, who is the most important part of any program, and for also being a part of the BSKB Youth Wing family and encouraging us to look forward to the next session every time. We would also like to thank the managing committee and the president for all their support. I would also like to thank Guru Prasad, Supriya, and Janavi Poti for all the coordination. Thank you everyone for watching. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel, and you can also follow us on Instagram by the name Youth Wing BSKBI. Namaskara. See you next time.
Thank you.